Up to 2 weeks of extensive testing and gaming on the ROG Strix Guard 2 and running into a couple of inconsistent benchmark results, we are now finally ready to conclude our review on this. So, is all that RTX hype worth your hard-earned money on this gaming laptop? We are about to find out. Let's do a recap of the laptop's hardware. The unit we received is the GL704, and it uses a Core i7-8750H CPU and RTX 2070 graphics. It sports a 17-inch Full HD 144Hz display, and while that might sound like it has a pretty big footprint, but in reality, the laptop is very much like a 15-inch laptop, all thanks to its slim display bezels. The display also has good color accuracy and decent brightness. Build quality is solid, just like what you would expect from an ROG laptop with an all-aluminum chassis and a solid display hinge. The ROG logo shines in RGB, and there is a RGB strip on the front. Both color schemes and styles can be configured in the Armoury Create software under the Aura Sync section. Port selection is decent, though there's no Thunderbolt 3. You get 4 standard USB 3.1 ports, 1 USB-C, mini display port, HDMI 2.0, Gigabit Ethernet port, and an SD card reader. Accessing the RAM and storage is easy by removing a couple of screws and the base. You get 2 RAM slots, and ASUS has done an excellent job by installing a single 16GB DDR4 stick. The laptop uses a 2-lane 512GB PCIe SSD by Intel that offers a reasonable transfer speed, though it isn't the fastest that we have seen. Storage can be expanded with a 2.5-inch SATA drive when you need it, but I wish ASUS could have given an extra M.2 slot for faster storage. In terms of thermals, the laptop has 3 heat pipes to dissipate heat from the CPU and GPU. Fan noise can get really loud at full load, but remains silent when doing web browsing tasks. I'm not sure why ASUS didn't make a side exhaust for the CPU's fan, as temperatures can get pretty hot at 94 degrees Celsius when under full load. Fortunately, there's no performance throttle, and GPU temperature is reasonable at 85 degrees Celsius during gaming. The work area of the laptop remains cool throughout my usage. The keyboard is great to type on, and the trackpad has great tracking performance. The laptop speakers are positioned well on the bottom left and right side. They sound really good with solid bass response and no distortion at maximum volume. Battery life is reasonably good. I managed to score up to 4.5 hours of usage on a single charge with heavy web browsing on Chrome. Now, here comes the most important part of this review: performance and benchmarks. One of the very obvious reasons you are looking at this laptop is all the bells and whistles that Nvidia has been hyping on RTX. Though I would suggest you look past that at this point of time, as there isn't a lot of game titles that does ray tracing and supports Nvidia's DLSS. But that doesn't mean that the RTX 2070 isn't capable of delivering decent frame rates. Using the highest graphics preset on Shadow of the Tomb Raider at 1080p with anti-aliasing off, it scored an average 75 frames per second on the in-game benchmark. On GTA 5, we replayed the Bureau Raid mission and start measuring frame rates from the point where we escaped from the FIB building on fire. It scored an average 85 frames per second with very high graphics setting with anti-aliasing, ambient occlusion, and tessellation off. Where the laptop really shines is on Battlefield 5, which we are able to measure an average 66 frames per second with ray tracing turned on and 79 frames per second with ray tracing turned off at ultra graphics setting. The last game benchmark we ran is the updated Final Fantasy XV benchmark with support for Nvidia's DLSS. We started off by running the benchmark at 1080p with high graphics setting and started recording the average frame rate at the battle scene. The RTX 2070 managed to score an average 55 frames per second, and the final benchmark result is rated as high. Turning on DLSS requires the benchmark to run at 4K resolution. We disable all Nvidia graphics effects while remaining other graphics setting at high to find out the best possible average frame rate we can get, and it doesn't disappoint. Enabling DLSS will offer 30% more average frames than TAA anti-aliasing. And fun fact, our gaming desktop with a Ryzen 7 CPU and GTX 1080 got an average 32 frames per second, which further testifies that DLSS does help improve GPU rendering performance by leveraging on deep learning and Texas last resource on the GPU. On 3DMark TimeSpy tests, the RTX 2070 surprisingly scores slightly lower than our gaming desktop. The ROG Strix Guard 2 is a solid gaming laptop with a great hardware design. It is available in 15 and 17 inch models, and you are also given two GPU options, either the RTX 2060 or 2070. The unit I have here retails at 9,299 ringgit. It is a hefty premium to pay for if all you want is to enjoy the RTX benefits while having limited game titles that support it and a marginal performance bump from the GTX 1070. Unless you're looking to do more on this, such as 8K video edits and 3D rendering, then you can't go wrong with this laptop for that kind of workflow. Alright, that's all for my review of the ROG Strix Guard 2. Let me know your thoughts and questions in the comments, give us a thumbs up if you like this, and be sure to subscribe to us for more videos coming right up. This is Warren for KL Gadget TV, and I will see you in the next one.